judiciam et judicia iniquitatem, propteria unsit te Deus Deus tuus, olio laetitiae per consortibus tuis. Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison, Christe eleison, Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison, gloria in excelsis Deo, et in terra pax omnibus bonae voluntatis, laudamus te, benedicimus te, adoramus te, glorificamus te. Gratias agimus tibi, propter magnam gloriam tuam, Domine Deus Rex Celestis, Deus Pater Omnipotens, Domine Filio Unigenite, Iesu Christe, Domine Deus Animus Dei, Filius Patris, qui tollis peccatum et miserere nobis, qui tollis peccatum et sitia per peccatione nostram, qui sedis ad dextrum Patris et miserere nobis, quoniam te solus Sanctus, te solus Dominus, te solus Altissimus, Iesu Christe, cum Sancto Spiritu in gloria Dei Patris. Amen. Dominus vobiscum. Oremus. Exaudite nos Deus salutaris nostra et sicuta beati Theresia, virginis tuae festivitati gaudemus. Ita celestis eis doctrinae populo nutriamo, et pia devotionis erudiamo affectu, per Domini nostrum Iesum Christum filium tuum, qui tecum vivere pregnati in unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum. Lectio Epistulae, beati pali apostoli ad Corinthios fratres, qui gloriatur in Domino glorietur, non enum qui se ipsum commendat, ille probatus est, sed quam Deus commendat. Utinam sustineretis modicum quid incipientiae meae, sed et superitate meae, emulor enum vos Dei emulatione, desponi enum vos univero virginum castam exhibere Christo. Specie tua pulchritudine tua intende, prospere procede et regna. Propter veritatem in mansuetudinem et justitiam, et inducite meribiliter dextra tua, alleluia, alleluia, aducentur regi virginis post eum, proxima eos afferentur tibi in laetitia, alleluia.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost, amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our
Mary Immaculate Queen, pray for us. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. Please be seated. My dear children and parishioners, today we celebrate the feast of a great reformer, St. Teresa of Avila, who died in Spain in 1582 at the age of 67. So that gives you an idea of the time frame in which she lived. An interesting little trivia point about St. Teresa is that she died on the night between the 4th and the 15th of October. So they weren't sure what day to put her feast day on, the 4th or the 5th or the 6th, etc. And you might wonder, well, how could that be? And the reason is the Pope at that time, Pope Gregory the 13th, wanted to reform the calendar. The calendar, which came from Julius Caesar, therefore called the Julian calendar, after 1600 years was off by 10 days. And so it necessitated dropping 10 days out of the calendar. So the Pope proclaimed that in that year, 1582, when he got to the 4th of October, the next day was going to be the 15th of October. And what's interesting is that the Catholic countries, of course, adopted that edict of the Pope, but the Protestant countries didn't, at least to begin with. Not because it wasn't a wise statement, but just because the Pope did it. And so in England, they continued to follow the Julian calendar for a number of years, and finally, all of Europe finally acquiesced to the Gregorian calendar. But it's just an interesting fact that she happened to die on the night when those 10 days were deleted from the calendar. Saint Teresa was born in the town of Avila in Spain, which is a little bit west of Madrid. And as a young girl, she was very pious. In fact, she had a great desire to bring about the mother ran away from home, and she's just a little girl, thinking that she was going to go to Morocco to convert the Moors and to die for the faith. That was the zeal that she had. And then at about the age of 20, she entered the Carmelite convent there in Avila. Now, the problem was at that time, sadly, because of human nature, even in religious orders, this can happen where laxity creeps in. And so the convent that she entered was in need of reform. And what happened is that even though the nuns are cloistered in a Carmelite convent, they would be able to go to what was called the parlor to visit through a grill with their friends. And there wasn't much regulation on that. So she was spending a lot of time in the parlor visiting with people she knew in the world before she entered the convent. And she knew that that was being lax, not giving her heart completely to God. And finally, after about 18 to 20 years, I've read 18 and I've also read 20, she had the grace to want to give her heart completely to God and to remove these distractions. And she went on to reform the Carmelite order. And there were many convents of nuns and even monasteries of men that followed her reform. She was joined in these efforts by Saint John of the Cross, who was also a Carmelite, and was persecuted very much for wanting to reform convents and monasteries where the religious did not want to be reformed. So she is a great saint who accomplished a great deal. She had a great devotion to Saint Joseph. She always prayed to Saint Joseph when she wanted to found a new house. Where would she get the means, etc.? And she said Saint Joseph never failed her. But another aspect of her life was the mystical side. She would have ecstasies. She would have mystical experiences. And she wrote a number of books, deep books, beautiful books. She was a very wise and prudent woman, very good in direction of souls. And so she wrote for her nuns books of spiritual direction. I read two of those books. One is called The Way of Perfection, a great part of which goes into detail about the Our Father and explains all of the thoughts that come to our mind when we meditate on the Our Father. The other book was her autobiography. She wrote others, but those are the two I read. And one thing that struck me in her autobiography is that she said that during that time that she was living as a tepid religious, that she was given a vision of the place in hell that would be hers if she did not reform, if she did not change her life and become more fervent. Can you imagine? That doesn't mean she was living in the state of mortal sin. She wasn't. But it was shown to her if she continued along that path of tepidity, she would eventually fall into mortal sin and was in danger of losing her soul. And so that vision, that knowledge helped her and spurred her on to change her life. Now, human nature is such, we always have a tendency to decline, to go downward from our maybe practices of virtue and of the spiritual life. We have to be on our game. We have to be on ourselves. We have to be on our toes, as the saying goes, to watch out in our lives for that tendency to be complacent, to be tepid, to be lax, and then to correct it. We always have to be dying to self and striving for holiness. So Saint Teresa is a great saint that helps us to aspire to holiness and virtue. Saint Teresa of Avila, pray for us. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost.
gratia segamus Domino Deo Nostro. Veri Dio magistrum est tecum in salutari nos tibi semper, et ubique gratias agere Domine Sancte Pater Omnipotens et Tenedeus, per Christum Domum nostrum, per quem maestatum tuam laudant angeli, ad hoc dominationis cremen potestates, celi celerumque virtudes ac beata seraphim, socia exaltatione concelebrant, cum quibus et nostras voces ut admici ubias deprecamur, supplici confessione dicentes. Thank you. Pater noster, qui es in celis, sanctificet nomen tuum, ad veniat regnum tuum, fiat voluntas tua, sicut in cielo et in terra. Panem nostrum quotidianum da nobis hodie, et dimitte nobis debita nostra, sicut et nos dimittimus debitoribus nostris, et ne nos inducas in tentationem, sed libera nos. Thank you.
Thank you.
Ecce sponsus venite, exiti obiam Christo Domino. Dominus vobiscum. Oremus. Satii asti Domine familiam tuum in eribus sacris eius quaesum semper interventioni nos repubre, cuia solemnia celebramus, per Dominum nostrum Iesum Christum filium tuum, qui tecum viva de pregnat in unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum. Dominus vobiscum.
The fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail, Holy Queen, Mother of Mercy, our life, our sweetness, and our hope. To thee do we cry, poor banished children of Eve. To thee do we send up our sighs, mourning and weeping in this valley of tears. Turn then, most gracious Advocate, thine eyes of mercy toward us. And after this, our exile, show unto us the blessed fruit of thy womb, Jesus. O clement, O loving, O sweet Virgin Mary, pray for us, O Holy Mother of God. Let us pray, O God, our refuge and our strength. Look down with favor upon thy people who cry to thee. And through the intercession of the glorious and immaculate Virgin Mary, Mother of God, of her spouse, blessed Joseph, of thy holy apostles, Peter and Paul, and of all the saints, do thou mercifully and graciously hear the prayers which we pour forth for the conversion of sinners and for the freedom and exaltation of Holy Mother Church through the same Christ our Lord. Saint Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our defense against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, thrust into hell Satan and the other evil spirits who prowl about the world for the ruin of souls. Amen. Most Sacred Heart of Jesus. Most Sacred Heart of Jesus. Most Sacred Heart of Jesus. May the souls of all the faithful departed through the mercy of God rest in peace. Saint Teresa of Avila. We will sing verses 1 and 3 of hymn number 67. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen.
Ave Maria. Sinless.